Hey, welcome to the 6-inch Show, episode 7. My name's Fly Guy, and I'm from flyguy.net, and joined with me, co-host of this show, this fine show about 6-inch Star Wars and Marvel Legends, is Matt from instagram.com/StarWarsTheBlackSeries and many other places. How are you doing, dude?
Good, mate. I'm doing good. All Force Friday'd out, but I'm good.
It's been an interesting weekend. Force Friday has came, so this is the Sunday evening after Force Friday for you and I. And look, I think we can have a quick rundown of our Force Fridays overall and what we did, but there's so much information to cover. So much. So that's what we're going to dedicate this show tonight, is just all about the new, pretty much all the new Star Wars products, all the 6-inch. We're going to go through all of them. Tiny bit of Marvel news and some of Matt's great cool collections, but Give us a quick rundown of your Force Friday. What was the experience like for you?
Look, I stayed up until midnight. I watched the Toys R Us live feed unboxing thing. Jumped online to check out what everyone was selling, which didn't kind of happen at midnight. It was about 12:30. It all went live from the different places. So yeah, I did that. Went to bed at about 1. Woke up at 6, got out to Toys R Us at 7, was fourth in line, and pretty much missed out on everything but a stormtrooper.
What? Oh my god. Okay. Well, you got a Luke Landspeeder.
I got that for Father's Day, which is the beauty of Force Friday meeting Father's Day. So yeah, look, it hasn't been a disaster by any count, by any means, but I got my stormtrooper, which is important, and the rest will come.
Force Friday for me was a very nice experience. A store in Queensland called Zing, and wonderful staff. They just made the whole night. We had such fun. There was drinks, there was candy, there was giveaways, there was raffles. They just made absolute fun, and they just made the whole evening great, because otherwise it would have been not so great. But they opened up the doors, and there was every Star Wars product you could probably want, apart from Black Series 6-inch singles, which I think, going from reports I've heard, and correct me what you've heard, but certainly across Australia, it was a little patchy. A lot of stores didn't get their stock, as far as I heard. I've heard from places like South Africa, where there was nothing. UK was a bit spotty as well, although actually not too bad overall for some people. Toys R Us seemed to be the place globally that kind of had stock. But I don't know about your readers or maybe what they thought, but certainly in the US, had people in kind of upstate New York area had nothing on their Walmart shelves. Friends in Tulsa went to about 4 or 5 stores, and there was stores with tons of stuff and just a few things, and then other stores who just did nothing. Crickets, literally. There was just nothing going on. So kind of weird.
Yeah, look, I think Black Series was Toys R Us in some places here. Target, I went to Target today. I went to a Target here in Sydney, and they had 1 375-inch Stormtrooper left.
Wow.
But they did have a section or a $35 price tag and an empty shelf, where I assume some Black Series were there on Friday. So what did I say? I saw that Iowa had tons, and maybe still does. A couple of people from Connecticut had a lot of success, but yeah, it's pretty patchy and a lot of complaints. A lot of people complaining in California as well.
Canada seemed to do pretty good. A few people, Seamus Gamist and a few other people on Twitter, G. Siebert and others, had tweeted to me and saying, oh, look, we got some stuff. And it just, I think that the one concern, and I had a bit of a rant, it was 4 a.m. or 2 a.m. or something when I did a video, and I was like, God damn it, Hasbro. And it's some ways it's their fault, I think, in some ways it's Disney holding everything back. It felt like this bursting wall of stuff. And then finally, we get, it's something like 200 files from Hasbro, or 120-odd, sorry, I'm like over-exaggerating, 120-odd image files and press release information in the one day. It's a lot to take in. What did you think? Do you think it was too much or too little?
Look, I think it was probably too much. I was trying to post as much as I could, and even then I called it a night, with still 4 or 5 more things to post. Which I got to over the weekend. But you know, I just think we could have had that first wave revealed officially beforehand. There was a couple of the exclusives could have been announced. I kind of take the theory that, you know, when cats are out of the bag, like Smoke, let him go.
I know. I think the thing that's very confusing is obviously this information is going to retailers and e-tailers. A lot of them have images, as we're going to show you tonight. There's images already out of Snoke from not the next wave, but the wave after. So I guess wave three, if you want to call it, of Last Jedi. That's not the exclusive, the single card. And we'll show you all that rose as well. We're going to show you that image too, which is clearly listed on an e-tailer. Why couldn't we have got that or been told about it before? It's just this mega miscommunication. And I think it boiled down to the point as well. It seems a little bit of a shame that on the evening, all this hype, every store, Target, US, Target Australia, Toys R Us, all these people had all their websites up and ready. And I said to a couple of stores on the day after Force Friday, and I said, well, your website's got this. And they're like, we never got anything. What a wasted opportunity for money and marketing just down the toilet. I think there's lots of kiddies and dads turning up and girls and guys and whatever. I don't know. Kind of 50-50, I think. What do you think? Like percentage overall?
Look, I'll go 50-50. I just think there's some really great things on the day.
True.
Distribution's always going to be the problem. And I thought maybe 2 years ago that 2 years later we wouldn't have that kind of problem. But it seems to be still the problem. So no. I don't know what can be done on that front. So
we had a savior though. Online was my savior, and I think has been some of yours as well. All the usual suspect, Darkside Toys, BBTS, Amazon, some Toys R Us places. Unfortunately, ours over here never list single products. They just, it's a random pick, which I don't know who buys, but never mind. Kind of weird. Yeah, 50-50, which again, I would have expected with budgets and all that money put into Force Friday, I would have expected more like an 80%. Get more product in, but I guess timing and logistics. But everybody who's watching, I'd love to know your thoughts. Let us know what you think, but let us tell us what you think below of how Force Friday went for you. Lots of stock, no stock, leave a comment, let us know. It'd be really good to get your feedback and find out what's going on. I did a little poll on Twitter through the weekend. I asked people, what do you think? Was it too much information or too little information? And at one point it was going all the way too much. And it balanced out to like 50-50. So there you go. I think a lot of people, like 30 or 40 people or something, responded. And so some people wanted more products. I don't know quite how you could have got it, but there's a lot of stuff still to come. A lot of these products that we are going to share here are not out yet. A lot of them are pre-orders. A lot of them exclusives. A lot of them have dates in December, October. You and I were just talking earlier on about some of the products are already marked as December. So they're not really out yet. But let's dive into all of the 6-inch figures, the exclusives and box shots and everything Matt and I have been able to kind of scoop up together. And let's go over them. So let's have a quick look. So we'll just go through these on screen again. If you're watching, what I've done is there's a little video I've made of literally most of these images pulled together from Hasbro. All the images they gave us on the day and the press release info for 6-inch is in a video. So again, that'll be in the show notes as usual below. But let us just share some of these images and start off with Snoke. Now this one, you know, we're talking about, this kind of leaked out in the last couple of days.
Yeah.
Hasbro did not send this to you and I at all.
No. So I think this was from
Amazon
in the UK. Yeah. So I was kind of against the whole Snoke thing, and I saw those Lego images a month or two back and the whole gold thing. And I don't know. The more I look at him, the more I like it as a figure.
Me too. And I think, and this, you can't say this without some weird innuendo in some ways, but I want to see what's under his robe. Purely, and no, I'm not worried about those things you're thinking of, but you want to see what's disfigured and what's going on. Is it just a dude, or is he wearing like a little bikini? Is he wearing a little gold medal bikini or something, or what's going on? There's been a few gold member Austin Powers things, memes already been done of this guy, which I think is quite funny. I love gold. So he's a little funky with his gold belt and his gold lamé. Dressing gear, and he's got little gold slippers.
Yeah, I saw that in a different picture. I don't know if that's maybe on the one when he's on the throne or something. You can see the slippers, but the soft goods look good. I know it's posed
Yep.
And stuff, but it looks good. It seems to work.
It does. It's a weird kind of. I mean, the sculpt looks great. They've added a little weathering into the eyes and the color, very pinkish. And he's obviously been in some scarring and battle of some kind because he's twisted all to hell. But yeah. So let us know in the comments if you want to see under a Emperor Snoke or whatever you want to call him's that robe. But it looks like it's a very disfigured body and kind of. Yeah, it'll be interesting to see what goes on. Can't believe I'm saying that. I feel really weird and pervy saying it, but you know what I mean, everybody. You know what I mean. Next up is, this is another one that was you sent me to. Was this Amazon.co.uk as well?
Yeah, it was.
Yeah. That looks, I almost thought that was 3.75 inch at one point. It just, there's very plain face, I think. There's no weathering, there's no... It's a shame. It's. I almost thought we were going to get a little bit more into the kind of facial sculpts, the facial scan stuff here. But anyway, it's not bad. But little, what do you think? Remote control. That's Finn's old blaster, I think, isn't it?
Not sure. I hate to say this, but I just think this one's going to be the peg warmer.
Yeah, me too. Me too. It's a shame. I really want it not to be. But I'm just looking down just now. Yes, that is. It looks very much like Finn's. Blaster, yeah, it is. I think pretty much just with a little bit of paint on it. It's got a little bit of arabesque here. No idea what that says. I'm sure someone will translate it. Resistance Tech Rose. I don't know. Rose is pretty popular already. I mean, we haven't really seen much, and already she's got a whole army of fans. Understandably, a lot of female fans too. Just to see another strong female character. Don't know. Could be interesting. But we in the categories. And there's a picture of Rose out of packet. I don't know. Be interesting to see if they've got somewhere to put this little device somewhere clipped on her belt or something. Looks like a detonator to me.
Yeah, it could be.
It's quite nice. Another picture of Jaina Solo. I think that's basically they've just removed the background. Because I think that was the one that we saw at SDCC with a black background, I think Hasbro sent us. I can't remember.
Yeah.
But yeah, she's looking good too. So it's another kind of newish or version of Jaina Solo. I think that one's going to sell and sell and sell. This got me frothy. I don't know about you.
Yeah, I am. I really like it. I think it's going to be a good one. It's good to see that they've put everything in there. Is there a picture of everything that's in there?
Yeah, that is indeed. So you only get one trooper, and something seems weird about his mouth. They've tweaked
sharp a V.
It is, isn't it? It's. I'm looking at two right now, and it is not as sharp as that. So I don't know whether the image has actually been pinched a little, but it seems very weird why that paint is so high up to a kind of high
point. Isn't there talk? I think that they have changed the. There's been a slight tweak to the helmet.
That's
true. I don't know what that tweak is, but maybe it's the. The V, I'm not sure.
We'll have a look at that in a minute. So we'll get a quick close-up of the goodies. We get a black thing. Don't go anywhere that's going, where that's going. Pistol. Kind of like a Death Trooper Specialist pouch, like an ammo pouch. Snowtrooper backpack. Macro binoculars, they're huge. The reused, that's the exact same pieces, isn't it? I'm just swiveling around and checking in the background. It is, it's reused, it's the same pieces. And we get a First Order Trooper. Exactly the same trooper, same arms, it seems. There's no difference. So basically, you need two of these, really.
Yeah.
One is the Heavy Gunner, and the other one is the Jakku Trooper. And really, there's a third, because the third is, it's another Riot Trooper, really. And then I don't know what these two are for, so it'll be interesting. We haven't seen any of the pack shots of the back, but you do get to see, there we go, you can see that helmet is quite different. That V seems much more prominent. Maybe they've re-sculpted the helmet, but they've sadly not fixed the arms. Oh, tell a lie, that is not a reused piece. That's the in fact, let me just go back and just double check, because they've got it folded down there, I think. Yep, wow, we got an extending part on a pivot.
There we go.
There you go. A little bit of a giveaway. So that's on, obviously must be someone swivel. So that opens up now properly to the way it should have been.
Finally, they could have given us the elbow.
I know.
I just want the, what do you call it, the Scarif Trooper elbow.
Yes, absolutely agree. And Stormtrooper elbow, the same kind of thing, just double jointed. So Shield looks the same, but yeah, it's so that you get a Riot Trooper basically combo. It's like Barbie, but First Order Stormtroopers. There's the Jakku Trooper. And there's the backpack on again. Regular Trooper, I guess, if you want to have another shot at a regular Trooper. And that's the Jakku Trooper again. And that was it, literally. So it's a cool looking pack. That's an Amazon exclusive. And it's up for pre-order right now. We'll put a link in the show notes. Thrawn in his regular box. Nice artwork by, what's the guy's name again?
Gregory Titus.
Gregory Titus, there you go. Thrawn's looking very cool there in his box. Yeah, not much I think we can say about that one. It's the same as the San Diego Comic-Con one we've seen. There he is again. Nice blaster, I have to say. That is a very nice little pistol he's got there with a silver touch on it. Looking good. Poe Dameron. Now, this is, we've got some other pictures that you mentioned later on, which we'll show, but. Oh, that's not
bad. I think so. I think it's gone a long way to righting some Poe wrongs.
Indeed. Insert Poe joke there. But he's looking very Han Solo esque with the jacket and the white kind of undersuit there. I mean, good God, that is Han Solo.
Yeah. It's going to lend itself great to customs as well.
Definitely. Absolutely. Cool blaster. Nice bit of silver on it. They definitely get the face a little bit more. There's a lot of criticism about the X-Wing pilot, which kind of ended up looking a little bit like Greg Gundaberg. It didn't really quite look like Oscar Isaacs, but looking forward to that. It has Wave 2 of the Last Jedi figures. And there he is there. Again, pretty neat. Not too bad. It's not facial scan technology, but it's not bad. Certainly the sculpt is there, as we would say. Yeah, can't complain about that. Pretty run-of-the-mill stuff. One of the many Praetorians. It's so easy to get confused in these things.
Keep track.
I know. Well, there's three. We'll show all of them here tonight. But these guys look very impressive with this kind of leathery. Did you notice that? This kind of leathery fabric they've got?
I hadn't seen it till now.
Yeah.
Really big mixed reactions on these guys on my page. Some people absolutely love them. Others are questioning their place in the Star Wars universe and whether they really fit. you know, I think, to be honest, if they're challenged by this, from what I've seen, they're going to be challenged by the whole casino scene.
Yeah, that's true. I think there's going to be a few surprising things in there. Well, this guy, I mean, you can go with a helmet design, but he has one single large blade, and the box just says Elite Praetorian Guard, but we do have a loose picture here for you. So you can see, and you can see much better that fabric-y, leathery, kind of weird indentation they've made on that. Don't know what that, I mean, it looks like soft goods plastic, but it just looks really, I don't know, kind of leathery or something. Plenty of articulation. Not a lot, I mean, he's solid red, so there's not a lot going on. Little touches here and there. I don't know. I think we're going to have the same problem with elbows as we do in the Stormtroopers.
Yeah.
Going to be very limited on that, on the arm side of things. No removable helmet that we know of, or any visor or anything that we know of. So it's just weird mesh. It's kind of going back to the 80s videos or something, like pop videos, but it's a weird kind of helmet. We get Maz, who's looking pretty good. We've got a nice photograph you shared earlier on. Very colorful, really detailed on that face, looking very weathered and Satsuma-ish.
Yeah, look, I was, as you know, on the last show, I was questioning my need for a getter anyway, but you know, the pictures are pretty good. I think it's probably jumping higher up the list than what it was.
I agree. Just looking very good indeed. That little wooden worn chest is a nice little diorama piece. And there's another picture of Maz, I think, coming up next. There you go. Looking very good. Lots and lots of color and detail and interesting stuff going on there. I think as an alien, she should be pretty popular. I think alone for that chest, I'm sure people will buy that for all sorts of dioramas. Little funky, weird boots there. Very cool. Maz, not bad. Not bad at all. Poe, which we showed on the last episode, again, reusing
Finn.
That. Poe, my apologies. Finn, thank you. Finn with a black blaster, a black version of the First Order Trooper. First Order disguise, I should say. Removable hat. And I think we got another picture, that same terrible picture. Yep, with a hat, kind of skew if. And a little bit. I just noticed the other day, Arabesh there. Did we miss that the last time? Anyway, moving on, what's next? Another Praetorian Guard. This guy has a heavy blade, as opposed to the other one, whose blade looked pretty damn heavy. Kind of upturned visor on this guy, and probably, I think, the same figure.
I think it is. That was the thing which was confusing me. They're both elite Praetorian Guards, so it's not like they're different ranks.
Mm.
But yeah. And of course, with the box artwork, this and the Obi-Wan figure are the first ones to put color.
I noticed that the white on the text, because obviously red would have just bled right into the box. I didn't notice it in the Obi-Wan, is that right?
Obi-Wan's blue. The Force Spirit.
Of course, that's right. This Force Spirit one, we'll get to that. The rainbow. My little pony, Obi-Wan. There we go. These heavy. This is going to be a pain in the ass to pose this thing. These weapons are just ridiculously big. But the body looks to be absolutely identical to the other one. So, yeah. No wonder Hasbro were happy with these things. You just swap the head and boom, there you go, with a different weapon. Interesting, kind of. I think that weapon there looks as if it's almost like an extending piece in some ways. Maybe in the movie they kind of snap and the weapons come out or something. I don't know. Interesting. I bet these guys end up being on screen for like a few seconds and we'll never.
They're going to be the Guavian enforcers or whatever it is.
They are. Not a very high res image here of Kylo, unfortunately, but. You've seen him before. We talked about him. Different suit, different kind of material, cape. Lightsabers look to be reused from the Kmart exclusive, I think. I can't recall, but his very ugly scar on his face, which is hit and miss, I think, on some figures. I've seen some with very prominent scars and some that were not so great. Here he is there, because again, you can't really see the scar there. It's very, very faint.
Yeah, it is really a 50-50 thing. The ones I saw on Friday, you couldn't really see the scar. And then I've seen photos, which I don't think have been customized, where there's quite a prominent scar there.
Mm. But a kind of slightly different figure in some ways. So, yeah, another one to buy. Luke, which we've seen, no lightsaber, but his metal hand, which is very interesting because we'll talk about that in a different version shortly. But he seems to be incredibly popular. People just are so desperate for this look. I guess core character, people really want him. What about you? Did you've got one pre-ordered or coming?
I've got one coming, but yeah, there's only three on shelf when I got there on Friday morning, so I missed him.
Yeah. And again, that hook for a lightsaber, which he doesn't come with. And notice the fabric there, that kind of Hessian weave, which I think is different on some other versions that we're getting from him, and I think it was different on the San Diego one, if I recall. Very nice Gregory Titus artwork on that box. I've already seen someone the other day with 9 of these. they just raided the store and bought 9 of them. So good luck getting them. So I think the box does look superb. It really does. Black and red. What's not to like? And you got one. So
yeah, I grabbed one on Friday. Look, I'm so glad they've re-released it. It made sense.
Yeah.
Apart from the 40th anniversary, they needed to do it for Rogue One anyway.
Yeah.
And, sure. You know, it was, what was it, Wave 2 of the original figures? No, yeah, Wave 2 or Wave 3. I can't remember. I should know. We've been doing them. Wave 3. It was about time they came back, and I'm so glad they have.
Yep, I agree. And there he is, posing in all his glory. So but basically, the same trooper we've had before, just repacked again. So, no worries. And Vader, again, repacked from the 40th anniversary. We've already had him and talked about him in previous shows. He's known red eyes, or slightly red eyes, if you get the variant. And either the variant with the cape up in the background or the cape where it's not up. So there's kind of, yeah, weird little variant things going on there. And there he is. Pose looks fantastic there. Really does look good. A great Vader. And Rey. So another version of Rey from her Jedi training. We see in the island, lightsaber, a staff, and her pistol. The fabric here, again, this is plastic on this figure here, but again, we've got a slight variation. Hasbro seem to be doing this. I'm sure you've noticed for the fabric now seems to be the swap out thing they can do for exclusives and
yeah.
that kind of stuff. So it's an interesting take on it, I guess. So there she is, the plastic of the fabric there. It's all it's the plastic of the fabric. It's all plastic, but we'll show on later on which is cloth. But that looks pretty good.
I was going to say, I wish they would do the variant exclusive of Luke Skywalker Farm Boy with a molded tunic.
Yes, I agree. And this is the one that was just kind of interesting. We don't get the front of the box shot for this. Litsky did not send that to us at all. So maybe there's some giveaway or something. But this is on, if I'm pronouncing it correctly, Crate, or C-R-E-I-T. And it's this red planet that we've seen speeders drag up the mud or the dirt, which releases a red cloud, which I'm guessing is there to kind of mask the rebels and their ships that are taking over those Arats, or the versions of the Arats. So, and there's the cloth fabric, which looks really nice. And I kind of think almost leathery plastic goods this time round.
Can you close up on her head? Is this the image where you can close up on her hair?
No, I can't get I can't get much. I might on the next one I will, but that looks, this one looks to be facial sculpt technology.
Yeah.
Whereas the other one wasn't. But that doesn't make sense why they would use one for the other. And I don't know. Kind of weird.
Because that doesn't have what the next one might show. And I think the figure shows bruising to the top of the eye.
You're right. I see it. I see it there. Just before we go in, look at the darkness in the fabric on this side and then the light there. It's very kind of quite clearly very different. The dark blue and then just grey. But anyway, we'll go look at the next pick. And there we go. Yep, you're right. She's getting bruised. Maybe that's what it is, bruising in the eye. So somebody's been beating a woman, which is not good. So quite different there. The fabric really makes a difference, as does that belt. It looks quite different too this time around. I don't know much use about that base, unless there's some other connecting part to it. It's kind of taken up with this huge lump here that you can't really do much with, I guess. But we'll maybe find it more in the movie. Looks good. But yeah, good point. She's got a bruise on her eye, so that's a little, maybe a little giveaway. Here we go. My Little Pony, Obi-Wan Kenobi. This is a little bit mixed. What do you think? Are you up for this? You like this?
Look, I'm up for it. It's strange. I'm an Obi-Wan. You know, they can't do wrong with Obi-Wan for me. At least Alec in this Obi-Wan. And look, it's an exclusive. I want it. But, you know, whether we need it is another thing. But, you know, I don't know.
I just don't like this personally. I think the thing that gets me is the purple negligee thing that he's got going on here. Just what? I get it, but yeah, no, it doesn't work for me. Leave a comment below, people. Let us know what you think about the Pony Obi-Wan. Is it for you or not for you? I'd love to know your thoughts. But I think if the cloth negligee thing had been kind of blue, I would have kind of got it more, but the purple seems really weird to me. I don't know.
Who knows how it ends up?
In ghost spirit force land, who knows? I know. No lightsaber. Is that right? Let me just double check.
Do force spirits have them? Well, I guess I was about to say.
Yeah.
His lightsaber was left behind.
That's but true. Again,
so was his cloak. So
his clothes are not left behind. So there you go. Good point. All right, moving on, and we get a gold member again in a different version, same figure, and this ring caused such controversy. So many terrible YouTube videos went on and on for ages making up stuff, and oh, this ring symbolizes this and that, and I call bogus. I don't know what you think, but
I've missed all the talk about the ring.
It's like whatever.
I think it's his fraternity from college.
Yeah, exactly.
Skull Club.
Sovereign ring. He's missing fingers. I didn't notice that there. His fingers are kind of chopped off.
No.
Which is maybe a little giveaway for something. We don't know. We don't know. But he comes with a giant chair. Looking very evil in that Gregory Titus artwork. That's, wow. He's not a, as I said in a tweet, a face for radio, this guy. He's like, hi. Kind of in his chair with his chopped fingers. He's got gold nails. Holy balls. There we go. He likes to paint his nails.
Is this the shot with his slippers?
This is the shot with his slippers. You can just look at, there you go, folks. Gold slippers. You saw it here first. it's just kind of bizarre, I guess, to see this. I'm just being stupid, obviously, but I am now desperate to see what is under this thing. What is he like? No body or something? I don't know. Very interesting. What's going on here? Cool little chair, but I don't know. What do you feel about this? Are you must have or whatever?
Probably not. Like, I mean, I look at it and go, I want it, but I probably just go for the single figure.
Yeah. Well, this is a GameStop exclusive in the US, as was the Rey and the Obi-Wan, as we mentioned. But this, by the time you get it in shipping in the US and sales tax is working at about 55-ish, 54 something US dollars. That's a lot of money for a chair. But anyway, it's a kind of diorama piece, so that's the way it goes. If you want it, go buy it. There he is, looking coy and kind of come and see me in my chair. Oh, we get a little bit of exposure there. He's showing off. So he's got a white robe underneath. There you go. So it's not all wrinkly, weird, missing body parts. Yeah. Very cool.
What's with the red lights and the blue lights?
I have no idea. His little, that's where he shows his movies or something. I have no idea. No idea. Not a clue. This is another, this is a Target, from memory serves, Black Series exclusive. This is Luke Skywalker, Jedi Master Ahch-To, Ahch-To Island diorama piece. Great artwork there again, by Gregory Titus. We're mentioning him every 2 minutes, but the artwork is superb in that box. Really, really good. And we get a little bit of steps for Luke. And his cape seems to be different here. There's something going on. There's definitely some fabric changes here. Because I think the other one is plastic. So
the other one's plastic. So the soft goods are on the exclusives.
Yep. So the cape color seems to be very different as well from the other one. And this also comes with a die-cast hand. A die-cast metal hand. So the front cover, Empire Magazine, you shared this on your channel, instagram.com/StarWarsTheBlackSeries. You shared a kind of pastiche of that with an Obi-Wan figure handing over to the Empire cover of the metallic hand. So kind of different that we've got. It looks like a closed fist, I think. And this is an open hand for a lightsaber, which this does not come with. Which, again, is kind of weird, given that Rey hands it over to him. But we'll find out more. What do you think of the base? You could use that for some other figures.
Yeah, I don't mind it. And I think it'll lend itself to photography too. You can place it on the edge of a cliff and it frame it. I think it works.
That's pretty good. And there's a little
Something simple, but I think most people are not going to be buying it for the base. They're going to be buying it for the soft goods.
Maybe we'll get a Porg in the 6-inch scale or something. We can plug the little Porg down there. I don't know what the other peg is there for, I guess, Rey. Maybe there's an extending piece on it. I don't know. That'd be interesting. I'm surprised they didn't do that, actually, like they did with Kmart's Kylo and Rey before and do a Luke and a, you know, a Rey.
We don't know that they won't because yeah, if you remember, true. I think it was Kylo was out first and it wasn't for another month or two until we saw the Rey that joined.
That's right. Well done. So nice little introduction inside the box. It shows the pieces there, and again the fabrics and things look very different to the inside of the box. I guess this is a kind of glam shot, but the steps look wildly different, much more weathered and wet and gray there, and much lighter in the picture. And there's his metallic hand, die cast fabric costume, die cast features, environmental base, and premium character detail, aka cloth. So there you go. And that's a Target US exclusive. No word on anything else yet. This is the Kylo Ren throne room. This is, I believe, Walmart exclusive in the US, if I remember the press release. And this one, pretty much the same. Different facial sculpt? I think it is.
And more importantly, that's a die-cast helmet.
That's right, yeah. And it looks quite different indeed. Premium character detail again, environmental base, which I think might have something to do with the chair that Snoke has. I don't know. Doesn't seem to be, as far as we can see. I'm sure they would have used that as a feature if it was. Diecast accessories and fabric costumes. So yeah, we go from plastic to this weird kind of grid-like parallel lines here, and yeah, metallic Kylo helmet. How did he get his helmet back? Anyway, we'll find out. He's got more than one. Keep a good Kylo down. What else we got? This is the Target US again exclusive. The First Order Stormtrooper Executioner. What do you think of this figure?
Yeah, I don't mind him. I think it's a... Look, it's the Stormtrooper, but putting the black and white into it's kind of... You know, bringing the kind of clone coloring and variation into the standard Stormtrooper, so I don't mind it. The weapon's a bit silly until I see it in action.
I've seen that, and we've got some SH figure arts to show as well very quickly tonight, but they've got a nicer weapon. This seems to be all in one piece of plastic. Oh, maybe not, actually. That looks as if these little blue... In fact, looks like the blue pieces do come off, so they're just kind of... Yeah. That's excellent. That'll make a difference, actually. You can get a couple of different poses out of it, I guess, in that way.
It's definitely a different V, isn't it?
It is definitely a different V. It seems much, much higher. I wonder why they've re-sculpted it. It doesn't make much sense when they're using the same body.
I think Rian Johnson's changed it for the movie.
Good point. I'm just looking. There is a difference. There is a difference in the helmet. You're right. There's grills on here on the side. That is not on the... or is it? Am I going mad? I'm looking at a figure as we speak here. No, there are little tiny girls on there too. I guess it's just because we're super blown up. I think what they've done on this one is painted them. You couldn't see them on the previous. I'm looking at two, one box, one loose, and you can't see, there's no paint on the previous grills. So that's what's added there that's quite different. But yeah, the V looks quite different there too. All right, that is, I think, pretty... Oh, no, there's one more. It's not the end. It's a trap. Toys R Us exclusive. Correct me if I'm wrong. This is the guy we saw from the first The Force Awakens, I believe.
Yeah.
One of the commanders on the guy that kind of panics and runs away, I think, that everything's going wrong. Reusing the Finn body and the First Order officer body we've had before. And... this looks to be all brand new, I think, pretty much, for Mr. Ackbar.
I've seen photos of this on shelf.
Yes, me too. I think it was in Canada, I think I saw it. Can't recall. But some people have got it. It's not up in ToysRUs.com yet anyway. Kind of weird two-pack. I have my doubts about this one. A lot of people have been kind of like, Peg Warmer, what do you think?
Look, I'll probably get it for Ackbar, but they could have picked another character to partner with him.
I think if you put another trooper in there of some kind, even if they'd split up and put the heavy gunner in there or something, I think that would have sold a little better. I don't know. Time will tell. What do you think? Leave a comment in the notes under the video if you're watching this, and let us know what do you think of these figures and all these exclusives that we're sharing. Is this going to be a peg warmer or not? ToysRUs.com or Toys R Us exclusive, and there's the working jaw, which is a nice little feature, I think, on Ackbar. A lot of scaliness going on in that figure. Little blue badge there. Looks pretty good. Can't complain, really. I think they're fairly standard figures. Nothing too off-putting. Don't know. And then these guys, which is a weird one. This is a first shared exclusive. Barnes & Noble, GameStop. Can you remember if there was one other one?
Yeah, there is. It's Disney Stores.
Disney Stores, there you go. So that would suggest there's going to be a bucket load of these guys out there.
You think Disney Stores in Australia will get them?
I don't know. Do we have any? We've all got one, haven't we?
I think we've got one at the casino here in Sydney.
I don't know. Look, I don't see why not. But it's, as you know, we're talking earlier on, it's already $10 cheaper at Barnes & Noble. I'd bought it at GameStop, or pre-ordered it at GameStop. It's not out for a little while yet. brand new Senate Guard from Attack of the Clones and Clone Wars. Anybody correct me if I'm wrong. Looking quite nice. They've got some kind of, you can't see it in this shot, but there's some nice kind of shoulder detail going on there. We get a repack of the Royal Guard, a repaint of the Royal Guard with a slightly different Force Pike from the Force Unleashed. And another Praetorian Guard, this little sad-faced one here, with double blades.
And a new helmet.
And a new helmet, you're right. He's got a weird kind of visor. He's got a, yeah. So let's get a look at them in a little bit closer up. You can't really see much more, I think, in this image, sadly. So yeah, complete repaint of the Imperial Guard with a slight tweak. And this guy looks like a butcher or something here with these knives. Chopping up the rebels. New blaster for the Senate Guard. You excited? Not excited? Couldn't care?
I'll probably pass on this one.
Probably pass that one, yeah. Again, peeps, let us know what you think. Leave a comment below. And I think that is us. These are basically the same images that we've seen before of Luke. And I think that's us. Rey obviously came out at the same time. And so did the, we've seen these before, the centerpiece images.
Which I'm going to say about the lightsaber, the land speeder. Mm. We were pretty critical of the Luke in hand. It is a much better head sculpt than it appears to photograph, either in the glam shots or on people's pages. It physically is a better head.
Yeah, it doesn't look too bad. I must admit, sometimes that the images that we take, that box is superb. I must admit, seeing the box in the flesh on Force Friday, just all the diagrams and the artwork on it, it's beautifully done. It's a really nice kind of design. And again, artwork by Gregory Titus. We need a little bingo card for people to score off every show, like Gregory Titus, Luke sculpt, Han Solo, boring conversation enemy stuff. Yeah, it's I like it. Yeah, that's good. And Rey's speeder, I think everybody get a chance to get a close-up on that. And the Rey seems to be outstanding. The speeder looks very good too, but the Rey figure just seems to be very nice. A lot of people liking the backpack's removable, and she just looks very nice indeed. It's a great-looking little vehicle with the, pardon me, kind of soft goods and the dents and the weathering. I love the other side with the panels which come off, which, I mean, they didn't need to do that, really. Steve Evans could have just saved some money and just made this entire giant orange lollipop thing, just, you know. But it's nice. I like it. It's a very sweet looking piece. Cool. That was a lot of Star Wars stuff. So what do you think in terms of money? It's there's got to be a lot of people completely broke by all this stuff. Did you think you overspent a little of this Force Friday or on pre-orders and stuff?
Not yet, but that's where I'm making choices like no throne and no, you know, just making those calls where enough's enough.
Yeah. It's a little hard for everybody to. I mean, I think what's nice and fair is that the Snoke does come with the chair, and if you don't want it, well, you can still buy the single. So there's ways of doing it.
Look, and I agree. I think that, you know, if you went back 2 years ago, there was one exclusive, really. Well, actually, that's not true. There's one exclusive to Toys R Us, which was the Snow Trooper with the orange pauldron or the red pauldron. Mm. There was the EE exclusive and the Amazon exclusive. So I think there's three exclusives Force Awakens year. Last year, there was the hover tank pilot. Then there's the EE four pack again. There might have been one or two more. This year, there's heaps. But
yeah, there's tons. There's tons.
There's pretty much alternates for most of them anyway, but
yeah, it does seem like an awful lot and an awful lot of money to land all at once, and I think a lot of fans, you know, they want to be sure to get them because they know what happens, the prices go up, and or some cases the prices go down, but I just want to get pre-orders in so I know I can get the damn things, because yeah, everybody will scalp it and make, you know, try and make $2 or something off it, ridiculous. But it just seems like an awful lot in one day for me. If they, you know, a couple of figures a month, a couple of exclusives every month, done. It seems just like, oh my goodness, my credit card's bleeding. And that's not even a single 3.75 inch figure, not even a single piece of role play, Nerf guns, masks, lightsabers, Beyblades, Beyblades, Blade Builders. There was a lot of stuff. Funko Pop, we haven't even, you know, that's not here, but it's a lot of Star Wars stuff all on one day. So for fans, it's a little chaotic, I think. But that's the way it is. Love to know your thoughts again, people. Thank you for all your kind emails and nice comments. I had a load of emails and long emails and short emails and just tons of information of people saying they love the show and they love what we're doing. And thank you for everybody who wrote in and asked and gave some feedback and corrected us on some things and told us other things were right and whatever it may be. So thank you for that. Some other figures very quickly. We don't want to spend too much time on this, but there were some other figures from Tamashii Nations. And Toy Art, as usual, did a great job of showing some of these off. Praetorian Guard with Heavy Blade, Praetorian Guard with Double Blades. Everybody's in the Praetorian Guard game this day. Jedi Training, Rey, Kylo Ren, First Order Executioner, Phasma, First Order Stormtrooper Special, all Tamashii Nations SH Figure Arts figures. And here's a little look at just some of the very figures there. It looks like a little Build-A-Figure part, I believe. I'm not quite sure what's going on there. Not quite sure at all what's going on. Not quite clear on some of that. But as a quick look at some of the images there. There's Phasma. I think this is the previous version versus the new version. So she's gone much shinier than the chrome metallic paint. She's got a little force pike this time. That's definitely from the new movie. So yeah, she's really metallic now. I had an SH figure. I didn't like it. But you've had a few you quite liked, didn't you? You liked the Han, wasn't it?
I like the Han Solo. The Anakin Skywalker is pretty good. Look, I grabbed them too. Oh, the R2-D2 is brilliant.
Yeah,
But the troopers, I bought them and I wish I didn't. The Hobbiton pilot and the squad, I don't know, people will talk about how great they are, but they look awkward. They look a bit like those Lego figures, like awkward arms, shoulders. Yeah. It just doesn't look right, but the ones that are outstanding, which I don't have, are the Mace Windu, the Obi-Wan Kenobis. Those Jedi figures are outstanding.
They do look good. They do look good. I mean, you certainly can. One factor is you get the ability to pose the arms properly, so we do get a bit of a bonus that way. And they look great there. But I think, yeah, like you, I think getting them in hand, something always felt a bit off for me. They're very light and don't feel very solid and chunky. There's something about them that, I don't know, but certainly nice little features that SH Figures has on the Executioner, for example, those blades pop out. They have a kind of, there you go, there's the different pieces. So you snap one off, snap one on. That's a nice touch. They've done some very nice stuff there. Different versions of the troopers. You've got a First Order trooper there with the orange pauldron. Maybe we'll get to see that again in the Last Jedi, I guess, the fact that they've marked it there. We've got another Kylo Ren, looking very predominant scar. Good facial sculpt there. It's pretty nice. Double joints at the elbows.
He's looking a bit Harry Potter.
He is, isn't he?
Alan Rickman?
Alan Rickman.
Alan Rickman.
Nice little picture there as well. Praetorian Guards, two of them. They look pretty good, I must admit, in that SH figure arts kind of guys. They definitely get the shine off the figures. There we go again. More shots, just skimming through these. All the different Praetorian Guards and their different kind of blades. So, I mean, maybe one if you want, if you don't. Oh, well, there you go. That's a different one. Wow. Okay. Sneaky little things going on there. Different blades and whatnot. Yeah, these guys are going to be very interested. That looks like a kind of mannequin or something. Weird.
It's kind of like you've got your kendo.
Yeah, yeah.
Kind of Praetorian guy, then you got your samurai one. And
yeah. Yeah, not the most exciting figure there. I don't know. We'll see. We'll see how big a part they make in the movie and what they get up to. We'll probably love them shortly, but yeah, very interesting. So again, SH Figure Arts doing plenty of stuff here. Rey, again, looking very nice. That is an exceptionally good-looking Rey. Bag and pistol and lightsabers and all the stuff. So, oh, two different heads. She's got the grittied head. And there's BB-8-2. That's incredibly good. That's very nice indeed. Yep.
Oh, that's a weird face.
That's a weird face. going to the dentist face. So, again, leave a comment below. Let us know, SH Figure Arts or Hasbro. What do you prefer? Like, none of them's going to win, but it'd be interesting to hear your thoughts and your points for and against. Tamashii Nations has got a little bit more information there. You can go through and check them out. It's in Japanese, but Google will translate it for you, and you can find a little bit more about what's in the pack. Definitely some stunning figures, as Matt said there. The R2 is pretty amazing. And that Mr. Solo looks pretty good, but I think you'd said in the flesh wasn't all that great, I think. But
he's still good, just doesn't live up to the those original prototype picks.
Yeah. So you get plenty of choices, 6-inch Marvel, 6-inch Marvel Legends, 6-inch Black Series or SH Figure Arts. You have a choice, peeps. One more little thing, I think, just to cover. Did we cover that there? Oh, I already did. Oh, no, one more thing is more Bandai figures. This time, they're Tamashii Nations. They're samurai-like figures. Three of them have been pre-orders have went up just in time for Force Friday. So you can buy Jango Fett, Darth Maul, or the Shadow Trooper. I just pulled together a little video there, but they're all up on Amazon if you prefer to buy there. BBTS has them, or places overseas in Japan like CD Japan or Hobbylink Japan, who are all reputable retailers and e-tailers. I believe Darkside Toys has them up now too. So there's plenty of places you can go and get these guys. These are superb. I've just immediately bought the Jango, and it's just rekindled my kind of passion for these guys again, because look at the detail on that thing. Love it. Very, very cool. I ask you this thing every, this is another one for the bingo card. I ask you all the time. You haven't got into this lane at all, have you?
I'm just trying to avoid it.
Oh, dude, they're so good. They're so good. Particularly the Stormtrooper is, and I just know you'd love them. The Maul's a bit of a kind of acquired taste, I think. If you look at some of the larger images of them, there's one particular image. These two are pretty shocking. That pretty horrific looking face there. But that is a mask. And underneath that mask, you then get, there you go. There's the creepy face. How gruesome is that? So lots and lots of little nice details on these guys. They look beautiful. They really do. So check them out. Don't, so this guy at Star Wars Celebration in the flesh, and he was, wow, it was absolutely amazing. They are particularly good, but a little pricey for a lot of people, $90. But that is it for Star Wars stuff. Did I miss anything? Did we miss anything there?
I don't think covered. So.
I think that's up to date. We're finally up to date. It's only taken us about 2 or 3 days to compile all the photos, make all the press releases, put videos up, put Instagram photographs up. There's a lot of stuff. So a little bit of Marvel Legends was found at Canadian Fan Expo, I believe it was. Or was it Hascon?
No, it can't be Hascon yet. That's next week.
It's not Hascon. Canadian Fan Expo it must have been. And where's the link? Where's the link? Get my link. Come on, Steve, get together. And what was showing off there by Hasbro at their booth was, and I'm not going to play this little video there, but build a figure for Sasquatch, which is a kind of just basically like, I guess you could call almost like a relation to Sabretooth in some ways. It's reusing some parts, I think, from some of the previous figures. In some ways, bits of shape, size, or form, somebody mentioned, but a lot of people don't seem too happy with this. I don't know if you saw this at all.
No, I didn't.
Yeah, it didn't really set the world. Most people are like, let's not too fussed about it. But Sasquatch is, he's appeared in a ton of Marvel comics, but some of them he appeared in with Deadpool. And Deadpool is, we believe now, Sasquatch is the Build-A-Figure for that Deadpool wave. And you can just see Deadpool down below this different version, which you and I shared in a previous show from San Diego Comic-Con. And there's a wave of Deadpool, basically, with Domino and other characters that are related to Deadpool. There we go. 6-inch Marvel Legends Deadpool with Sasquatch Build-A-Figure. So that's the Build-A-Figure for the wave. The wave's going to sell anyway, but a lot of people, as you can see there, somebody said, I'm beyond pissed. They had so many better options to pick from. So, yeah. Ugly. Didn't like this figure. So the internet is not kind. It's, yeah, but there you go.
Look, I had some guy on my page this week with someone that one of the maybe the Target Luke things, like, Black Series sucks. Hasbro sucks. No, that's like, you're on the wrong page, dude.
I know. Go to the Whiners and Complainers Instagram account and just don't get people with that. Anyway. Yeah, that is that. What else do we have? That's Marvel Legends. There's nothing else new that we know of. Thor Legends still is the wave that's in stores right now. Expect a lot more soon. Lizard Wave, I think, is the next one coming up. We're going to skip the Back to the Black series. And thank you to the person who wrote in to tell me it's not 6 years, it's 5 years or something like that close to. I appreciate it. We'll go with your suggestion. Yes, so it's not quite 6 years, it's 5 years apparently, give or take. But still, we'll come back to the Black Series history stuff and we'll continue that on the next show because we've spent so much time on this stuff. So, toy collector kind of a corner, toy photography corner, I should say, just before we get into your posts and have a look at some of the stuff, dude by the name of Starpool295 sent me, Tyler Pickup is his name. Sent me some photographs and he wanted to share off some pictures he'd taken. He'd taken some very cool pictures there with Hera, but it was the R2 pictures that I thought were particularly good there, just showing off the SH Figure Arts version, which again we were just saying is a particularly cool looking figure. It does look superb, it really does. So I'm a little bit kind of tempted to get this thing now after your praise and his praise. So
I think it's one to get of all of them.
It's just really, I love the colouring one. It's just that off-white kind of, it's the right colour. It looks really, really nice. So yeah, he's another Instagrammer. He's got a lot of cool little pics. He's just kind of starting out. And there's some great pics he took of 3PO and R2 there as well. They look very good. They look really, really good together. I think the R2 just definitely works. So maybe Hasbro can go back one day and correct or do something. Something weird about 3PO, I think, as we'd said before in that SH Figure Arts version.
The head and neck.
Yeah, something's not right. It just doesn't feel right, but we're such fussy buggers. So there you go. So thank you, Tyler, for your getting in touch. And he was a big fan of the show. So thank you for watching. What else do we have? Photography time. All right. So let's kick off with you had a couple of photographs here. So again, if you don't follow Matt, you should. Star Wars, sorry if I keep getting this wrong, Instagram.com/StarWarsTheBlackSeas. How can I forget that? I forget it every week. Top five wants. Tell us more. What's this all about?
Oh, look, I just think there's been so much as we just covered. So much. Sorry. Got my baby waking up. I think it's my little one.
No worries. If you need to disappear, I'll carry on here.
I'll let you know if I hear anything again. Okay. Look, the top five ones is so much to digest over the last two or three days. So I kind of looked at everything that was either announced or leaked or put on shelf early and made my list. And in no particular order, I think my list was Poe Dameron. I just think there's so much to write with the previous figures. And, you know, I like him as a character, so this figure's high on my list. Mm-hmm. Rex, of course, who was already revealed, but next week will come out at HasCon. So
yep,
that one's on the list. The Kylo is the one that I want. Cape's a bit weird, but again, it seems better. Mm-hmm. Or much better, and that die-cast helmet is incredible.
Yep.
The Luke's the one I want. And is that number five? I know. And then I'm there with Obi-Wan.
My little pony.
Yeah.
Okay, interesting. I would disagree with some of them, but on the whole, I get your points. But I think that's the point, and we can all have some fun with this. So if people want to go to this post, and we'll put a link in the show notes, or just go to StarWarsTheBlackSeries.com and look for the top five wants. Or I think you said they could leave a comment underneath that there, or
tag me in their post or use the hashtag, I think, TBS top five wants.
Come on, tell us what five figures you want, and that'll be kind of interesting. We'll see exactly what happens. That'll be interesting. General Leia, people are saying there. Slave One ship, I like it. Nice. Captain Rex, Akbar, Yeah, that could be a very interesting bunch of comments in there. Cool. Nice. All right. What else have we got? We got some other stuff in the show notes here, which, again, if you want, they'll be under the video. Trusty Sidekick. Tell us more. These get some other photographs here. Yeah.
Look, I just found these just before the show, and they're really clean, great images of the figures. Better than the Hasbro glam shots.
Mm. I think that's one thing that's nice that shows up is we were showing the fabric with that kind of design earlier on. It's on the plastic too. It's quite nice.
Yeah. Mm. I think the cape does work in the plastic in a very limited pose.
Yeah, sure. Yep. Capes are just kind of silly overall, really. They don't really do it. Yeah. They're not very practical. Yeah, that'll be interesting too. Yeah, it's just different to see the different shots there. Ray in the flesh. Yep. Bad. Yeah. I think once that facial sculpt really comes in, it's going to make such a big difference that the way they're doing it in Marvel Legends, if they do it on Black Series. I like that look. That facial sculpt looks great.
Yeah, I think it works. And, depending what angle it is, how it's shot, it looks a lot better. And I just wish I had one in hand. So I could have a look at what it looks like in hand.
Soon. And there's that poor again. Yeah, that does look good. I like that.
Nice. Looks like Oscar Isaac.
It does. It really does. Be great to see if the head swap does go on that X-Wing pilot. There'll be a bunch of these figures getting bought, that's for sure. That's a cracking Leia. It really does look like her.
Yeah, I think they did a great job.
Yep. I think, again, hashtag the sculpt is there. I think with just a little bit of weathering, as a fact, one of the photographs you've got, I think it really just does show up. So, yeah. Nice to see these in the flesh. Thank you, trusty Sidekick. Oh, there's the Praetorian Guard, or one of them. There you go. He likes it. Freaking awesome. And Hera and Maz. Looking great there. Looking really, really good. Nice pecs. He's done a good job there. Kind of bluish filter or something, but it really sharpens up to see the figures' kind of details there. There we go. Cool. Good Force Friday for him. And we also have on your page here, let me just go back to this here. Yeah, this was nice. This is
the, that's incredible.
That was nice.
We're gonna get it.
Yeah. So this is the South P24. This one there. But yeah, they've obviously repainted or tweaked the look, put them in a black suit, I guess.
Yeah.
And different fabric and Ray. Nice shot. Very dark. Can't really see much, but very nice.
Look, I think my prediction, I think I put in there, is that it'll be a New York Comic Con reveal, and it will play out like the old man Han Solo did. So maybe what, March or something? Maybe it'll be the spring, part of the spring wave or something. But we need that Luke.
Yeah, we do.
If that's going to be the Last Jedi Luke, we're kind of getting the Force Awakens one now.
Yep.
This is the one we need. Maybe he'll come with the staff. Still no lightsaber.
Mm. Interesting photographs just where we go through. So yeah, that photograph was by South P24. He's got some very cool stuff on his page there.
That's yeah.
Good looking look. Damn. That's awesome. Love it. Takes me back to the comics. Nice. A lot of cool stuff on his page. Check out South P24. And we had one other one here. We can't play this little video because YouTube always goes funny when we play video, but the maker, the man, the designer, he did adverts. So two little adverts by Steve Evans there. And we were just talking about this earlier on. He's flipping fab in them. He's really, he's like... He's so good at presenting this stuff. So, yeah, well done. You've done a really good job of not only designing the damn toys, but presenting them. And he does a little skip where he runs in from, I guess, a Death Star corridor. But he's really good at doing this stuff. And he's one of the only guys, I think, at Hasbro that seems to be really getting news out there. He's the one guy who shares stuff. And it's kind of hard to see stuff. Otherwise, there's the Obi-Wan there. Nice. And he's Force Friday stuff. Not been his page in ages, actually. Cool. You can follow him at Mr. Stevie18. And that, I think, is it. Now, we've got a quick look at your page just if there's anything else you want to highlight. There's a couple of things which I thought were particularly good.
That execution is good, and Han and Leia next to each other. There's that horrible look.
I know.
The Goonies look.
I know. There's so many memes going around about this eyeball already. So, Kylo and all the pack shots. Nice little shots there of Thrawn and Hera. I missed this, actually. I should have known about it. The space walls, which we've talked about many a time before. Got to pick
they've extended the offer.
Oh, there you go. Saw. There you go.
I think it was meant to be Force Friday, but they've extended the offer.
Excellent. There you go, folks. If you're watching this in time, maybe not, but check out, get some space walls for a good price. So, I'm going to do that after the show. And there was other some things over the weekend as well. Dark Side Toys, I think they still have the damn thing up. $15.99 for a brand new The Last Jedi figure. So, there's a link in the post, or click on over to Dark Side Toys and grab one if you want. So, yeah. And this one, I think did we talk about this the last time?
No, we didn't. The Empire Toy Shop has done in the past the colored clone troopers, where he's broken them up and you can buy them as individuals. And what he's done now is both the Crimson Trooper and also the Sand Trooper. It's a five pack for, is it 99? I can't remember how much is it.
It doesn't seem like a quick look. We'll go to the page. But that's that. Yeah, there's a good way of army building if you want to, just split the boxes up and get the ones you want. Let's have a go. Yeah, $100. 20, 40, 60, 80, 100. So, I mean, that's pretty fair.
It's a really great price for Sand Troopers.
Yeah, it is. That's very, very true. Yeah, he's got a lot of other stuff. $5.99? Say what?
That's the pre-order deposit, I think.
Oh, gosh. I'm like, I'll take 100. Oh, wow. Good stuff. He's got some nice stuff up there. Like that. EmpireToyShop.com. Check him out. Anything else?
Just have a quick look. I think just next to the Akbar and Imperial shot there, that Kylo Ren is a custom cape, which is great.
Let's have a look there. Oh, is it? Okay. Yeah, so it is. It's kind of flowing. I get it. Yeah. That's by CJE Sim. Nice.
And I think if we go down a bit more, there is maybe, keep scrolling underneath that Gregory Titus one. That shot on the left is in, stop there next to Force Friday. That one is incredible.
Oh, wow. Floating stones.
This is from Jeff Darkside since 77.
Nice. I like it.
And there's these rumors of this shot kind of thing, so
floaty stones. Nice. I like his little monitor. I love this, the oversized Kylo in there. Nice. See, there's one of those figures. You gotta get one of them, man. Gotta get one of them. That's nice. Very nice indeed. All right, folks, if you want to find out more great Star Wars images and stuff, I love all this. You'll get some great shots on the page. There's Dark Side Toy Stock, I think. Yep. God, they get tons of stuff. Instagram.com/ Star Wars The Black Series. Check them out and follow Matt, and you'll be in good company with nearly 100,000 other people. So there's plenty there. Anything else you want to talk about, plug, pimp?
No, I'm going to be overseas next week. So hopefully by the time I'm away for 2 weeks, but hopefully by the time I get back, I'll have some kind of news or something that I can share, and we'll wait and see.
Cool. All right. It's probably a long show and we've got a lot of stuff in it. So we'll wrap it up and we'll be back with another show and we'll carry on with other stuff. Maybe there'll be some more news for some new releases. Let's just slow it down. But we'll go back to the usual kind of format and other stuff. So thank you again, everybody who watched, everybody who sent an email, everybody who sent a tweet, direct message, YouTube message, YouTube comments, tons of you. So thank you very much for doing that, both on Matt's page and mine. We only do this because it's fun, and it makes more fun when you guys tell us it's fun. So thank you for doing it. that's it from me, and we'll see you soon.
Cool. See you next time.